We are left with almost 40 days before the prelims. So what will be our strategy? Some of the things that we must take care. First of all, last 40 days, how to divide these last 40 days? What should be the overall division of last 40 days? So we should divide in three categories. Phase one, where we will work on the weak areas and the left out areas. So this phase one will be approximately 21 days duration. That means 3 weeks time. Okay. So here you will be working on those areas which you consider your weak area. For example, some of you are not confident in science and technology. So you will give slightly more time to the science and technology, and you will give time to other subject as well. Okay. When I'm saying focus on weak areas, do not mean only focus on one or two subject. It means inside each subject, there are some topic. Some of you might not be confident in, say, the species in the environment. Some of you might not be confident in the mapping part in the geography. Some of you may not be confident in history and culture. So inside the history and culture also, there are some specific topic which you are not confident about. So you should focus on those particular topics, right? And those areas which are left out earlier, like you have been postponing them, that you will cover later, you will cover later. And those topics which were never covered earlier. These topic can be less important topic as well. Suppose you have been studying in last 5-6 months, but you don't cover those topic, thinking that first let me cover the important topic and the less important topic I will cover later on. So because of that thinking, you have left certain topic which are not covered a single time in the last 6 months or 1 year. So you should cover those topic so that there is a sense of completion. And these topic which are less important and which you covered today, like in the phase one, these topic you do not cover in the phase two and after that, because only one reading you have to give to those topic. If there is a question, the question will be very easy and the question will be, you know, not attempted by everyone, right? So this is the strategy of phase one. Okay, so let me share with you how we can divide the time in the phase one. Again, the file that I'm going to show you and that I'm going to share with you is a, you know, standard file which you can customize according to you. Okay, so we will share this Excel file with you. You can go through this Excel file, and this is the strategy according to us. Okay, but for you people, it is quite possible that you are very good in, say, economy, so you need only less time in economy, but you need more time in history, so you can spend more time in history. Okay, so you can modulate this schedule a bit. So this schedule starts tomorrow, that is 29th of August, and you can follow this in this manner. Okay, so in this manner, this phase one will complete on 18th of September, and it is exactly of the 21 days, that is 3 weeks exactly, right? So in this 21 days, what we have done, we have divided the day into three portions. 5 hours for the static portion daily, 5 hours for the current affairs daily, and 2 hours for the MCQ practice, right? I will come to which MCQ you should practice now. And coming to the static portion and the current affairs portion, static portion and current affairs portion, again, suppose I say medieval history, you have to complete in 2 days. So you have 10 hours for completing the medieval history. Now in 10 hours, identify those topics which are weak for you or which you could not cover earlier, and first focus on those topics. Don't try to complete 100% topic, because that is humanly not possible for you, right? Similarly, art and culture, science and tech. Again, I am emphasizing, please modulate this, like customize this plan according to you. You can make a bit change as per your requirement. So we will share this Excel file with you. This is editable. You can change it and you can follow that. Okay, because I understand that if I share a plan with you, that may not be suitable to each and every person. And if you follow the same plan, if everyone follow the same plan, that is not a proper way, because not everyone is weak in same area, right? Are you getting my friends, everyone? Now comes the phase two. Okay, so after phase one, we will have phase two. In the phase two, you will work on the high priority areas. Okay, high priority means in every subject, there are topics which come every year. like in the polity fundamental light. In science and technology, the questions come from space or defense or computer science. In suppose modern history, the question comes from freedom struggle part 2 and part 3. In ancient India, the questions come from Buddhism, Jainism. In CSAT, the questions come from average or percentage or reading comprehension, logical reasoning, some of the particular topic in those subject. So the point is, those topic which are bound to come, right? So after the phase one, you are confident that you are not left out anything. And you are also confident that I have already worked upon my weak areas. In the phase two, you are working on those areas which are high priority areas, even if those are not your weak areas, right? I will say, even if you are confident in those topics, but still you should go through once, that will increase your recall capability in the examination, right? Do not think that I already know this topic, sir. Why should I revise it again? Revise it so that your recall capability is increased. Your chances of doubting your own answer is less in the exam hall, right? Coming to the phase three. Okay, so what is the duration of phase two? Phase two will be approximately 2 weeks time, like around 12 to 14 days. Okay, again, I'm sharing a plan with you. Phase two will start from 19th of September and it will go till 1st of October. So again, it will be approximately, 13 to 14 days, right? 2 weeks time. Here again, we will be sharing a day-wise plan with you. You can follow that. And alternatively, you can choose your own plan. Like you can change the sequence of the subject, or you can even change the time that you need to give. Suppose you need to give less time to the modern history, so you can give extra time to other subject. Okay, so depending upon your requirement. Coming to the phase three, in the phase three, you will be revising from the revision register. Okay, I'll come to what is the meaning of revision register very soon, right? Is it clear, everyone? Phase one, phase two, phase three, how you have to proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Now, let's come to what is the strategy. After the time division, let's discuss each and every area. First thing that I would like to discuss is the revision register. Okay. So I recommend to everyone, please make a revision register. What is this revision register? Okay. I still, remember in my student days, my aspirant days, I qualified prelims 5 times. I did not qualify in the first attempt. After the first attempt, I started making the revision register. What is revision register? Whatever you read from today onwards, you will have two kind of topic. In some topic you will feel confident, and in some topic you will feel, yeah, I don't know whether I will be able to recall it or not. You are not confident, right? So what you can do, you make a revision register. In that revision register, you will make maximum 100 pages. Please note it down. Maximum 100 pages. That means maximum 10 pages for one subject, because there are approximately 10 subjects. So maximum 10 pages for modern history, maximum 10 pages for economy. I will say try to keep it in 5 pages, 6 pages. I'm talking about A4 size papers and front and back both separately, not inclusive. So 10 pages for each subject, and in that register you will just write that particular point which you are not confident about. Suppose you are devising from economy, and there is a topic about this LTRO. Okay, now this LTRO, you are not confident, or when you are solving the MCQ, you make a mistake again and again. So you will just write LTRO and you will write that particular point which you are struggling in. Now, in this manner, what is the benefit? You may not be getting the same question in the exam hall, but doing this kind of exercise will increase your confidence. How it will increase the confidence? Because when you are writing those things where you might forget the things, or where you might struggle, you are writing that in a separate register, and that register you are revising before the exam. This revision register you will be revising in the phase three. In phase three, you will not do anything else apart from revising from the revision register, right? So phase three will be all solely based upon the revision register. You will be revising this revision register at least 3 times. So it will make you super confident, because when your weak area is already covered, when your difficult area is already covered multiple times, and you are confident in that, then you will have a peace of mind. And you know what happens in the exam hall? When you enter the exam hall, it is more about your confidence level, less about your knowledge level. The more you confident are, the better your common sense is, better your alertness is, and you are able to solve more questions correctly, and you are making less mistakes. This is a psychological thing. So work on the psychology, okay? From the knowledge part, I want to tell you one thing, and mark this word. You will get this kind of feeling when you come out of the exam hall. Even if you do not read single day from now onwards, it will not make a difference in your preparation, right? You know, on the other hand, you can say, sir, last 40 days are there, I have to do everything in the last 40 days. And let me tell you, whatever you have prepared so far is more than enough. If you have been sincere in last 6 months, I'm talking about last 6 months sincerity. If you have prepared 3 months full time for the prelims and 3 months part time for the prelims in the last 6 months, then your chances of clearing the prelims are equal, even if you don't prepare from now. The only difference that will be there is your confidence level. If you're confident that you have covered everything and you can recall everything before the exam, then your examination is automatically done, right? So you should make a revision register. Now, what to do in the revision register? In the revision register, you will write, first of all, things to be kept in mind during next revision. So in the phase one, you will be working on weak areas and left out areas. Suppose you think that I need to go through some particular fact or some particular chapter or some particular page in the phase two, because I will not be confident if I don't revise that area before the exam at least once more before after the first one. So you should write, okay, page number 20 of this booklet, or page number 30 of this booklet, or you will mark in your booklet, or you will be take out that page and put it in a separate folder. Means you have to make a guideline kind of thing, that what is your revision that you have to do in the phase two. You have to write tricky concept and facts. Suppose for me, geography has been very, very challenging. Like, I always felt underconfident in the geography. So I will always write small things about geography in my notes. Even those very, very silly information I will write, just to ensure that I do not make a mistake anywhere. And you know what? My questions of geography were never wrong. Never. Because I feared so much in geography. I used to write tricky concepts, tricky facts in the register, and I will revise them again and again. And my weak area became my strong area in the examination, right? Third, you should also write type of mistake that you are doing in MCQ solution. So I will soon discuss how to solve MCQ and which MCQ to solve one. So in the revision register also, you will be making a segment where you will be writing which mistake I am making. Suppose, are you making the mistake in elimination of option? Are you making a mistake that you are not able to recall a particular concept, or you are reading the question in a wrong manner? You are not reading the question carefully. You are making a mistake like you are not reading correct, incorrect, or not option very clearly. So whatever, very silly information, very small information, you will be writing in the revision register. This is how you have to prepare the revision register. This will be your friend, best friend in the phase three. And this will become your source of confidence. Now, coming to the daily revision time, the daily time you have to divide into 4:1. 4:1 in the sense, 4 hours of study, 2 hours of MCQ solution, right? If you are not confident in CSAT, some of you might not be confident in CSAT, then add 2 hours in the CSAT also. So then it becomes 8+2+2. Or you can do a small modification, 7+1.5+1.5. If you want to do in 10 hours, then 7 hours of study of a GS, 1.5 hour of CSAT, and 1.5 hour of MCQ solution of the GS and CSAT. So this is the daily time division. Now coming to the MCQ. Sir, which MCQ to follow? First of all, previous year question. Even if you have read previous year question multiple times, even if you have read them 10 times, not a problem. Again, go through them, because if you go through the questions and the options again, you will be very, very closer to the examiner's mindset, right? The kind of choices that they are giving, the kind of statements they are making, where all they are making those tricky things. Science and tech may what kind of questions they are making, application-based concept and all. So whenever you read a particular topic for the revision, please go through the previous question again. If not all the questions, at least few questions, at least have a glance of the previous questions. Maybe you can see randomly, maybe suppose you are revising the chapter of say climatology and geography. So you can just attempt 5 questions randomly from the previous question, right? Then second priority you will give to those MCQ which you have already practiced in the past. Okay, so all of you must have practiced some MCQ in the past, maybe from some test series, or maybe your own set of MCQ, or maybe you joined some program of daily MCQ at Didymi IES or out of Didymi IES. So you can revise those MCQ from there. Okay, whatever mistake you did at that time, identify those mistake, identify your own behavior pattern, like which kind of mistake you have been making, and what tricks you learned from there, what facts did you learn from there, revise that. Okay, if you don't revise, then no need to practice new questions, because new questions practice will not give you benefit unless you revise those topics which you have already practiced. Number three, third priority will be given to those areas and subject where you are weak, where you are not confident. Suppose you are not confident in environment. So what will you do? You will take one subject wise paper of the environment and take its hard copy from any bookshop. Okay, you can contact me if you want a link of the bookshop. I will tell you. Call them and tell them that I need 2 paper of the environment or 1 paper of the environment from any any institute. Okay, it can be like anyone, maybe Insight, maybe Vision, I don't know, like you can take anyone. The point is you take new sources for those subject which you are not confident in. Solve that in hard copy, right? And don't try to solve daily 25 MCQ, daily 30 MCQ. That period is gone, right? Don't try to do that now. I will not suggest practicing new MCQs for every subject. Practice new MCQ for all those subject where you are not confident, where you have weakness, and practice in the hard copy, not in the soft copy, because in the exam hall you will be practicing the hard copy. So you should have an OMR sheet with yourself and you should practice in the hard copy. Don't practice in the soft copy now onwards. Then you should practice full mock test, at least 2 full mock tests every week. 1 full mock test of GS and 1 full mock test of the CSAT. Again, this should be done in the hard copy and you should have the OMR sheet with yourself. Exactly in 2 hours, you have to practice. You should exactly replicate the examination condition, like without any disturbance, complete 2 hours. You have to sit on the study table, practice it, and in the next 2 hours, revise and analyze your problems. Okay, maximum 2 hours you have to give that to the find your weaknesses. Okay, don't worry about how many marks you are getting, how much is your score. Rather, you should more focus upon what mistake you did, what did you learn, what tricks you should have applied, or what concept you should revise in the next phase. Okay, whatever mistake you do, make a writing in the revision register. Revision register will be your single place where you will be writing everything that you need to keep in mind in the next phase. Okay, so that you don't have to come back to the book, you don't have to come back to the MCQ bank again and again, because you will not be having the time to come back. Okay, you are practicing the paper today, you won't have a time to come back to that paper after 30 days or after 20 days, right? So this is the overall MCQ strategy. So please don't ask for the daily MCQs. That will not help you. Rather, practice previous question, those MCQ which you have already practiced, get a hard copy of those paper which you are weak in, and practice full mock test in the hard copy format. Is it clear, everyone? This should be the MCQ approach. Clear, everyone? Yes, no?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Now, some of the tips. First of all, do not change your sources at this time. In Telegram, YouTube, Google, everywhere you will get last time revision notes, right? You will get, okay, 50 pages, 100, 50 pages or 100 pages important revision notes like that. Don't refer to any other note, because our mind has a photographic memory. If we revise from the same source which you have reading in the past, then you will be able to recall in the exam hall. Number two, focus on scoring subject, polity, environment, economy, modern India. Even if you are confident in this subject, but again, focus in the scoring subject more, okay? Solving current MCQs. If you have a choice between current revision and current MCQ, go for the current MCQ. And definitely after you cover the current affairs compilations, after that only, not before that, okay? CSAT. So what should be the strategy for CSAT? Number one, in the CSAT, the previous year questions are the best guide, okay? Because the question paper will, the pattern will repeat. So what you do, take up the previous year question paper of last 3 years, like 2018, 19, 20, and revise from there. In fact, what you do, you practice in the exam conditions. Identify the pattern of your mistake, pattern of your answering, and how many marks are you scoring, right? After that, you go through the topic-wise previous year question of last 10 years, like starting from 2011, because in 2011, CSAT was introduced. So now you have a question bank of 10 years. So 2011 to 2020, whatever questions have come in the CSAT, you will be going through in the topic-wise manner, and you will be solving them in the topic-wise manner. Start from your weak area. Suppose you are good in reading comprehension, but you are not confident in quantitative ability. So start with the quantitative ability. In the phase one, daily 2 hour maximum you should spend, 1 hour, 1.5 hour to 2 hour. And you should practice those previous question. Try to solve them logically. See their solution if you are not able to solve them, okay? And in the phase two, you go to the other areas which are important, high priority areas, even if you are confident. Again, solve one CSAT paper every week. So now onwards, how many weeks we have? Approximately 6 weeks we have, approximately 5 to 6 weeks. So before 10th October, you should be solving minimum 5 CSAT full length papers. So that practice you have to continue, okay? Work on your weak areas. And 2 hours daily maximum. Okay. And this is a big area where students falter. I have seen so many students, they have been preparing very good in the GS, but they end up losing in the CSAT. That is a very bad thing. So you should not make that kind of mistake. Okay. Now, what are the Diademy IAS initiatives for the revision? So we are coming up with a Chaipe revision series. Chai Pe Matas Master Tea Time Division Series. So what we'll do, we will share 10-minute video on the core areas, those areas which are really important for you. This series will cover all the subject, every subject it will cover. And for every subject, there will be 5 to 10 videos maximum. We will be working on the pattern analysis, the areas which you should focus upon, and really, we will not just overburden you with those things which you already have. We will try to give you some crisp things in the 10 minutes maximum. So you need to register for this. We will share the link in the Telegram channel. And the good thing is that this will be very, very easy to follow, because what we will do, we will share the link of the video on your personal WhatsApp on a daily basis. So before 4 p.m., you will get daily link of the YouTube video on your WhatsApp, and you open that link in 10 minutes, cover that lecture, and after that you will get 2 MCQ which will be based upon that 10 minute question series, the 10 minute revision series. Solve those 2 MCQs, send the answer to us in the WhatsApp. So in that manner you will be engaged in this revision. So this is a kind of small booster that we'll be providing, our team faculty will be providing to you. Second, we will have a weekly question answer series. So we will have a session on a weekly basis where we will be sharing MCQ solving hack, how to fill up the OMR sheet, how to manage last time stress. And there are a lot of problems that you people will face when you falter in your planning, when you do mistakes, when you implement the things. So in weekly question answer session, which we'll have on Saturday or Sunday, we will discuss all of those problems which you are facing on it in the revision plan. We will also provide you doubt resolution facility. So you can anytime send us an email or our official email ID contact@academy.com from any subject. It can be about technical subject. It can be about current affairs. It can be about your, maybe psychological stress or challenge that you are facing. Our team will reply to that. We will send that query to the relevant subject matter expert and you will get a reply. Even you can get a one-to-one phone call with the subject matter expert. Okay. And tips and tricks sessions, again, those will be covered in the weekly question and answer series, which will be done live. So we will try to invite the people who have qualified the prelims in the last 2-3 years and what tricks they have used in the prelims, right? So this is everything that I wanted to share about the revision strategy. Now your questions, my answers. Crisp notes, when we will get crisp notes, which notes you want, Rahul?
So, good afternoon. So, you have said, in the last month, we will give you the crisp notes of every subject. So, like, you have shown us of the modern history.
And no, I mean, they...